I want to give you my secret for relatively easily solving rational equations.
Pay attention, son. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
A rational equation is going to be an equation that contains fractions. Now, this is going to be the most useful and most commonly seen equation because life doesn't come at us in whole numbers most of the time. You don't always eat a whole cake. You eat a part of one. So get used to it, and it's not that difficult to solve them. They're not going to be that bad if you remember the secret. I'll show you. This is going to be a job for our superhero.
LCD Man.
Just remember, LCD Man is a superhero. He's lower than low. Always keep it lower so it's easier to work with. And he's going to be able to cancel, if he in fact is the common denominator, going to be able to cancel out all the denominators, thereby getting rid of all the fractions. That's the idea.
LCD Man.
But just remember, whatever you do to one side of an equation, what we're going to do is multiplication here. Whatever you do to one side, you always have to do to the other side, even if it doesn't look like it needs it. So that's what you're going to have to remember. So to solve a fractional equation, we're going to multiply everybody by the least common denominator. And I say the least common denominator over 1 to emphasize that it's in the numerator, thereby canceling out denominators. In this case, it's 6, and watch what happens. 6 cancels the 2, leaves you with a 3, and I have a 3x for that term. 6 cancels this 3, leaving you with a 2, and I have a 2x for that term. Now, the other guy doesn't need canceling because he's not a fraction, but he still has to get it to be fair. And look what I have. I have an equation with no fractions.
Excellent.
Now all I have to do is solve it, which you should know how to do. I'll add like terms, get x alone by dividing by 5, and there's your answer. Not too bad, huh?
Do that again.
This one will work the same way. Don't get nervous. Call on your least common denominator. Now only look at the bottoms and see if you can figure out what the least common denominator is. 5y, 7, and y. We'll need a 35y to get rid of all of those. Let's try it. That's going to cancel, and I'm going to get a 7. Of course, the 7 times a 6 is 42. Nice non-fractional expression. 7 will cancel with 35y, leaving a 5y, and I'll get 10y. The y's are the only thing that cancel here. Look, you've got an equation with no fractions. Now, you should know how to solve this.
Excellent.
Let's subtract 42 from both sides to get y alone, and then divide by 10. Now, it doesn't go in evenly. This is the big leagues. Get used to it. You're going to get fractional or decimal answers because that's real life. And that's the answer in this case, 6.3. Wasn't that bad, was it?
Genius. That's what it is. Sheer genius.
Now, this also works for quadratic equations. But let me remind you the secret for quadratic equations specifically. Remember, we use the zero property to solve these type of equations. We get a zero on one side, factor to create multiplication, and then figure out what it takes to make each of the factors, what x needs to be to make each of the factors be zero. That's the zero property.
Excuse me, Professor Brainiac.
Let's try this one. Look at these bottoms, and what's your least common denominator going to be? P plus 1 and P. Now, a P plus 1 is not going to be able to cancel with a P because you can't cancel added terms. So we're going to need both a P and a P plus 1. Now, let's multiply everybody by that. This will cancel, and nicely in that expression we'll get minus 6P. That saved a lot of work, didn't it? Now, in the middle here, I'm going to treat that as a negative 4 times P and then times P plus 1. Let's do the P and the P plus 1 first. It doesn't matter which ones. And I'll get P squared plus P. Now, multiply minus 4 times those. You see, when you multiply three things, you have to pick two of them to multiply first. And I just happen to pick the P and the P plus 1. Now, in this case, the P's cancel, and I'll multiply the 3 times P plus 1, and I'll get 3P plus 3. Let me put these common terms together. And I notice that I have a quadratic equation because of the P squared. So I'll need to get a 0 on one side. I'm going to get a 0 on the left because I hate to have a negative P squared term. So I'll add P squared to both sides. And I'll add 10P to both sides. And there's your 0. Now on the right side, let me put things in the right order. I put the 4p squared first, then the 13p, that's the 3 and the 10, and then the plus 3. Now I have a 0. It's time to factor, isn't it? Now we have it factored, and we're going to take each of the factors and see what it takes to make them be 0. Well, with 4p plus 1, if I solve, I'm going to get, dividing by 4, negative 1/4. That's one of the answers. With p plus 3, I bet you could do it in your head, but let's solve just in case. And the other answer is p is negative 3. But note that this multiplying by the least common denominator over 1 is going to work for all of these equations that have fractions in them.
I'm trying to think, but nothing happens.
I bet you're salivating on this one. It looks easy. Let's bring in the least common denominator. Very easy, isn't it? We'll cancel x plus 2's, and I get negative 2. This is really cleaning up nicely. We'll cancel this x plus 2, and we'll get x. Well, son of a gun. Oops, I thought I was done. What's the problem? What I've been forgetting to do,
Houston,
is put the answers back into the equation. Remember, if you have to check these answers. Sissy on me. If you put negative 2 back into these equations that have fractions, remember with the rule of fractions, you can't have a 0 in the denominator. That negative 2 would have made at least two fractions here. It only takes one to have a 0 as a denominator. So I have to throw that answer out. So actually, in this case, I had this one does not have a real answer. So you got to be careful. Always check, especially with fractional equations, check your answer to make sure that it's right and to make sure that it doesn't create zero denominators. Don't let this one scare you. Look at that. Do this one in front of your mom. She'll get a kiss. Well, we're going to have to find the least common denominator. We can't do that until we factor. Remember that before LCD man has any power, he needs his assistant. Okay, let factor boy help you out here before you use LCD man. Factoring the denominator of that middle term, I get, well, let's start again. I'm going to get x plus 3 and x plus 4. You love that x plus 3 and x plus 4 because now you know what the common denominator is. It's just x plus 3 and x plus 4. Now it's going to take a lot of writing. Might have to do it sideways to fit it. But that's what the LCD is, and it's going to cancel nicely. Let's try it. The X plus 3's cancel here, and I have to distribute the 3 to the X plus 4, and I get a non-fractional 3X plus 12. In this case, it looked tough, but everything cancels, and nicely I get 12X plus 19. And finally, in this one, the X plus 4 cancels. Now be careful, that's a negative 5 times X plus 3. So I'm going to get negative 5x and negative 15, aren't I? Because negative 5 times 3. Okay, not that bad of an equation. Let's put like terms together. In this case, and in this case, and now let's get all the x's on one side. I'll subtract the little guy. And now let's get x by itself. Subtract 4 from both sides. Divide by 4. And there is your answer. Can you believe it? Now I'm going to look and see that if 2 makes a 0 out of any of these denominators in the original problem, and it doesn't seem to. So I have an answer, and that's pretty cool. It works every time. Okay, so go try the homework. Dig in.